Hello from Plattsburgh, this is Calvin Castine. I'm at South Acres Field. We're here for game number 3 in a best of 5 between Barcomb's TV and Rigsbee's Auction. Rigsbee's leading this series 2-0. This is Dale Hawksby, he's leading off for Barcomb's. Pitching for Rigsbee's is Danny Caron. Hawksby's first pitch is going to be hit deep. Where'd he go? There he is. Kind of lost behind the players here. That's one down. Well hit ball. This will bring up Dean Lombard, pitcher. The manager for Barcomb's, Bill Bayshore, handed Joey Trombley and Dean Lombard the scorebook and said, "Surprise me." After last night's 18-3 drilling, he wanted something different, so he let them make out the lineup tonight. Hit to center field, this should be caught. That's out number 2, I believe that's Brian Foster out there. That is indeed Brian Foster. This will bring up Randy Barcomb, the left center fielder. On the ground, Cleland will take it as short. Throw to first in time. That's 1, 2, 3. Three up and three down for Barcomb's TV. We're going to go to the bottom of the first inning with no score in the ball game. And Rigsbee is coming to bat. I'll give you the defense for Barcomb's. Pitching is Dean Lombard. Behind the plate, Tracy Boris. First base, Joey Trombley. Second base, Todd Underwood. Shortstop, Dale Hawksby. Third base, Rob McDonough. And left field, Jim Barcomb. Left center field, Randy Barcomb. Right center field is Bill Bayshore, and in right field is Steve Southwick.
Come on, guys! Come on, guys!
Bayshore must have changed that because they had Southwick in right center and Bayshore in right on the lineup card given me. And Denny Laporte is the extra hitter. This is Mark Riel. He's the right fielder. He's going to lead off here as I get my cameras lined up. There's the first pitch from Lombard. It's going to hit the front of the plate for strike one. I checked with Bob Hall, the interim league president. As far as the art goes, he says 3 feet from the point of release to a maximum of 12 feet from the ground. And he says 12 feet from the ground is 2 feet over the backstop. Southwick picks it up. Steve told me he was going to scrape the Teflon off his glove. Nothing would stick to his glove last night. So he's going to try to scrape the Teflon off and hang on to the ball tonight. This is Danny Caron. Of course, the whole Barcomb's team was suffering from that Teflon glove last night. That contributed to the 18-3 loss, although the umpteen home runs that Rigsbee's hit also contributed to that loss. So one on and nobody out. Caron hits it up the middle. This could be two. Hawksby goes to Underwood. The first double play, yes. That's a pick-me-up as far as Barcomb's is concerned. This will bring up Keith Riel. He's the left center fielder. There's the backstop. That's 10 feet above. I'll zoom in over here to the pitcher and we'll have an idea what the arc looks like coming from Dean Lombard here. There's ball one. We'll look at a few from each pitcher and you'll get an idea. May have had a little bit of height to it, but not enough. Ball two. Three and oh, excuse my coughing.
Hit the ball.
Strike one, 3-1.
Hit the ball. Come on,
which one, George? Come on.
Ball four, Riel will walk to first. Oh, with two down. And a runner at first, Lonnie Cleland, the shortstop, will step in.
Hi, Lonnie, move him, Lonnie. Come on.
Wind is blowing in tonight, so this could be too much arc. Yep. Oh, strike. Somebody said too much arc, but umpire said strike. There's a ball. Wind blowing in, so that might be in Barcomb's favor. Barcomb, with the exception of Denny Laporte and occasionally one of the other fellows. I know I've seen Barcomb, Randy Barcomb, hit it over the fence here. Doesn't really have that overwhelming home run power, so it's a wind keeping the ball in will help Barcomb's. More than that would help Rigsby's. Hit to Lombard. He'll go to first.
Loosen up,
guys. So it's four up and three down. And after one full inning, there's no score in a ball game. We'll go to the second inning. This is Denny Laporte. He's the extra hitter tonight. He's going to EH. It's a lot easier on my camera doing these games with Karen pitching with early in the evening like this. At night with the bright lights glaring off that high forehead of his. It gives me a little trouble. Laporte pokes it to left center. It's grabbed out there by Keith Riel. This will bring up Todd Underwood. He's the second baseman. Ball one. As a strike. Too much arc. You see, he went off the top of our screen there. To the left side, Cleland. He plays a deep shortstop. He threw that into the stands here. Throw going to come to second. That's going to be safe. Underwood safe at second. Cleveland's throw came close to going over the fence. It went back here into the league officials. Oh, there's a runner at second. One out. And Joey Trombley stepping in. He's playing first base tonight. Side, ball one. Strike. To the right side, nice knock down. Throw to first in time. It advances Underwood. It's a good play by the first baseman, Gary Fassett. And this will bring up Rob McDonough. He's the third baseman. Inside, ball one, two down. Runner at third base. We're in the top of the second inning here. Two balls and no strikes. Three and oh. Here's a pitch from Karen. Ball four, yes. McDonough will trot to first. Runners at first and third. And Tracy Boris, the batter. All right, strike one. First and third, two down. Boris, the catcher tonight. The center field. That's out number three. It's taken by Foster, the right center fielder. We're going to go now to the bottom of the second inning with no score in our ball game. Glenn Vassette will be the batter leading off the second. He'll be followed by Brian Foster and Randy LaValle.
Come on, come on! Right now's when you dig down, fellas. Come on. Come on, Mo.
Like I said last night, Brian and I.
Right here, Mo, right here.
Right back to Lombard. Nice catch by Dean Lombard. Well hit ball, but Lombard was equal to the situation. This will bring up Brian Foster. He's the right center fielder. Popped up, back a short. Hawksbee will grab it at the edge of the grass. That's two down, and Randy LaValle, third baseman, he'll be up.
Come on, let's go.
Come on now, come on, keep going.
Wave it on him. We gotta hit the ball. We gotta get up and play ball. We're not up, we're flat. Get ourselves up. Come on, keep going.
Come on!
It's Rigsby's team, very subdued. There's ball one. Their noise level is usually equal to that of the air base when a plane is landing. There's a strike, no arc, they said. 3 feet at least. I didn't really get a look at that. Plenty of arc on that one. There's a chopper, Lombard. Nice backhanded grab. Throw to first.
Come on, let's get a little fired up.
So nothing across for Rigsby's. And we're going to go to the third inning. No score in our ball game. Defensively for Rigsby's, pitching of course is Danny Caron, behind the plate Greg Fassett, at first base Gary Fassett, second base Alan Fassett, shortstop Lonnie Cleland, third base Randy LaValle, in left field Glenn Fassett, left center field Keith Riel, right center field Brian Foster, and in right field Mark Riel. This is Bill Bayshore. There's the first pitch. There's strike one. Pitch number two. Swung on, line right to third. LaValle grabs it. One down. This will bring up Steve Southwick, the right fielder. There's ball one.
Come on in here.
Ball two. Slow roller. He'll beat it out. That's the type that ends up in no man's land. Greg Fassett out from behind the plate. Couldn't pick it up in time. So we'll have a runner with one out and...
What's the baseline for? As long as he don't interfere with it.
doesn't play on it. This guy turns around, doesn't play on him. Check your rule book. Don't have to make him play. Let the play out.
Gary Fassett arguing that Southwick was not running down the first baseline. He was in fair territory instead of being in foul territory. This is Jim Barcomb. Starting right there, the runner is supposed to be in foul territory. Barcomb could be hitting into a double play here. Cleland the second for one. Southwick broke it up a little bit. So we have two down. And Jim Barcomb at first. And this will bring up Dale Hawksby. Ball. Taken by Foster in right center field. So nothing across for Barcombs. At the 2.5, no score in our ball game.
Wake up, Brian. Come on, Mark. Way to be there. Way to
talk. Hit the ball!
Run to hit. Brian, way to get there, Brian.
Alan Fassett will lead off. He'll be followed by Greg Fassett, and he'll be followed by Gary Fassett.
Come on, Alan, they can find it, Alan.
Watch in.
Come on, guys.
Come on, guys, I want the
magic. Come on.
Go away. Come on.
Come on, Alan.
There's a pitch from Lombard. Drops in there. Randy Barcomb over to cut it off. Throw to second. Oh, double to start the inning off. And this will bring up Greg Fassett, the catcher. Nobody out. Third inning, no score in our ball game. Strike one. Too much arc. One and one. Ball is in play. And I'm in play too, so I got the heck out of the way. That ball was in back of me. I was standing directly between home and the ball.
So
we have runners at second and third. And Gary Fassett, the first baseman, will be up. It's going to score two, I believe. No, it's going to score one.
Come on,
it's Rigsby's team, a feisty team when they're doing well. I've never seen them when they weren't doing well, so I don't know how they are when they're losing. This is Mark Riel. We have a run in, runners at first and third, and nobody out. Tom Lee is going to go home. Throw was low. A good idea, but the throw was in the ground. And Bowers couldn't hang on to it. Well, goals is the fielder's choice. I wouldn't consider it an error on either one of them. It was a fairly good throw, but it wasn't a perfect throw, and Bowers just couldn't dig it out of the dirt. This is Danny Karen. Two runs in, runners at first and second. And nobody out. Pitch from Lombard. Hit to the right side. It's going to be through. That's going to score a run. Throw's going to come to third. And Teflon is striking again. Another throw with a short hop, and McDonough couldn't hang on to that one. Both balls, one that Boris couldn't hang on to and one that McDonough couldn't hang on to. Would have been good plays if they'd hung on to them. But those are the type of plays that you have to make if you're going to win these ball games. There's strike one. And a batter here, Keith Riel. Complaining about the arc. This one's hit deep. Steve Southwick with a nice grab. That scores a run and moves Karen up to third. Lonnie Cleland, the batter. I have one down now. Hit to the right side, that'll be through. Throw comes into second. Karen scores. I believe that's four runs. And the batter will be Glenn Fassett, the left fielder. The strike. Hit it. 2-1. Just barely missed. That's ball three. 3-1. Popped up. McDonough grabs it. That's out number two. Cleland stays put at first base. And let's bring up Brian Foster, the right center fielder.
Move him, Brian. Move him, Brian. Come on.
Come on, Brian. Get here.
Come on, one, three. Get your...
Come on, Brian.
Runs up on it. This could be trouble. Lombard. Throws. It gets through. Tom Lee. Nice sweeping tab by McDonough. Umpire right on top of the play says that he was safe. Oh, another run scores for Rigsby's. I've lost count. Let's bring up Randy LaValle, the third baseman. We have no way of telling from this angle if that tag was made or not. All we know is that the umpire's decision is going to be what happened, whether it did or not.
Good call! Good call!
Play the game! Hit the ball! We don't want charity! Come on, Randy! Hit it in!
We're not swung at that anyway!
Green light, Randy! You're the guy who can hit a ball if you like it! Make it yours, though!
Up the middle, knocked down by Hawksby. Comes up firing in time, yes. That's going to take us to the fourth inning. Our score is 6-0. And the story tonight is similar to the story last night. Good hitting by Rigsbee's and less than perfect defense on Barcomb's part. And Rigsbee's is leading 6-0. Dean Lombard will be the batter. And this Barcomb's team looks like they're at a wake instead of a ball game here. I think their season just died on them. There's ball one. The right side, that's going to be foul. A slight crowd here at the ball game. Immediately following this ball game is going to be the third game of the Bowl Mart Press Republican series. That's inside. There's a strike. A very subdued Barcomb's bench. Inside. Count is full, I believe. Lombard looks at ball four, so he gets on. A leadoff runner here for Barcomb's. So bring up Randy Barcomb. Hard hit ball gets by in the left field. So the first two runners are on for Barcombs. This will bring up their power hitting designated hitter, Denny Laporte. There's a ball. A strike, 1-1. Pitch from Karen. Hard hit, that's through. That should load him up. Bases are filled. Nobody out, and Todd Underwood is the batter. Foul territory. That puts Barcomb's in the scoring column. It's a 6-1 ball game now. And this will bring up Joey Trombley. Trombley looks at ball one. To right center field, Foster grabs it. Underwood tagging, they'll give him third. Runners at first and third with two down. And Rob McDonough, the batter. Well, Barcomb's had their first three runners on, but they've had only two fly balls since then. McDonough inside, ball one. A chopper to Karen. Karen will toss to first. Oh, Rigsby's holds him to just one run. And there's Barcomb team. Looks like they've conceded the ball game. They've given up on this ball game, and after three innings. Right now, we're going to the bottom of the fourth. Our score, Rigsby's 6, Barcombs TV 1. Alan Fassette will be the batter. Swings at the first pitch. Bayshore stumbled, but fortunately it wasn't hit too far away from him. He was able to catch up to it. That's one down. And as we bring up Greg Fassette, the catcher.
Okay, come on now. Got it, Greg. Got it, Greg. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come
on. Strike one. Too much arc. That'll be ball one. One ball and a strike. That's a base hit. Oh, a base runner with one out. And Gary Fassette will be the batter. First baseman.
Come on now, back to kick.
Strike one.
Come on, Dad. Come on, Dad. Get down. Come on, Gary. Come on, back to kick.
Come on, Gary. Come on, Gary.
Yeah, all right, Gary. Come on, Gary.
Come on, Dad. Be off on yours.
One and one. Ball two. On the ground. Underwood goes to Hawksby for one. They get the lead runner. That'll be two outs, and Mark Rael, the right fielder, will step in now.
Good shot, Matthew. Good shot.
Come on, what?
Move him, Mark. Move him, Mark.
Come on, Mark. Come on,
Marky. Right now, Marky. On a bad one.
Strike one. Too much arc. Ball one. Southwick going back, going back. He dropped it. Hit that a long way. Southwick caught up with it, but couldn't hang on to it. We'll have to call that a three-base error. And Denny Karen, the batter here, he's the pitcher. He looks at ball one.
Everybody knows what they want.
No arc at all on that one. That was a strike. And a strike. So you can see that glare up there in that high forehead on Karen. There's the ball. Runners at first and third. I believe a run scored, as I recall here.
Score him, Rico. Come on.
This is Keith Riel. Yeah, we got a 7-1 ball game here. Two outs, runners at first and third. Keith Riel is going to pop this one up a long way. That's going to drift over the fence. Bounces across the road off a car. A chopper, Hawksbee, nice pickup and a nice tag. Nice play by Dale Hawksbee. After four full innings, our score, Rigsbee's Auction 1, Barcomb's TV and Furniture, Rigsbee's Auction 7, Barcomb's TV and Furniture 1. Tracy Boris will be the batter. Lead off the fifth inning here. There's the pitch from Karen. Inside, ball one. Popped up. Cleland should have it at short. He does. That's out number one. So one down, and Bill Bayshore will be the batter. A line shot right to Karen. Nice play by Dan Karen, that pitcher. A bullet hit by Bayshore, but Karen grabbed it. Out number two, and Steve Southwick will step in here. Too much arc. On the ground, Cleland throws the first. Oh, three up, three down. After four and a half, we're going to the bottom of the fifth. Our score remaining, Rigsbee 7, Barcombs 1. Lonnie Cleland will be the batter to lead off the bottom of the fifth. Umpire checking the score. And Jeff Rozell has arrived. There's a ball hit by Cleland going deep. Caught by Bayshore. I was checking out Jeff Rozell, who just arrived. The results from the Ormsby's post 16-19 game. I'm sure Ormsby's took that game that they were leading 13-3. This will bring up Glenn Fassett. He's the left fielder. He lofts a high one. Steve Southwick said he got it, but boy, he was a long ways away when he said it. And he just barely got it. That's two down. And a batter here, Brian Foster. He's going to swing at the first pitch and foul it down the left field side for strike one.
Come on, big guy. That's your swing right there.
Come on, Brian! We had some changes here that I wasn't really paying much attention to. Tracy Boris has moved in to play first. Umpire said his foot was off the bag there. This is Joey Trombley pitching now. And Dean Lombard has moved behind the plate. This is Randy Lamalley, the batter. Strike. Underwood throws to Boris. That's going to take us to the sixth inning. Score is going to remain 7-1. Rigsbee's leading Barcombs. And Barcombs continuing to be a down team. You would think that score was 17-1 instead of 7-1. Jim Barcombe is the batter. He's hitting at the bottom of the lineup, and for a very important reason. Trombley and Lombard are filling out the lineup. They had it all filled out, and they were starting to put into positions, and they realized that they hadn't put in Jim Barcombe, and the only place to put him was at the bottom. So that's where he's batting. A very scientific approach. He's leading off this inning. Usually bats toward the middle of the lineup. Got a ball.
Come on, Jimmy boy!
Hits the edge of the mat. LaValle. For the first in time. One down. And this will bring up Dale Hawksby. Pitch from the left side. Strike. Too much arc. On the ground, Karen with a nice pickup. Throw to first. Two down. And Dean Lombard will step in. We're in the sixth inning. Rigsby's is leading 7-1. Barcombs has all but conceded the ball game. That finds its way through. So Lombard will be aboard. And this will bring up Randy Barcombe with two outs and a runner at first. Strike one. Too much arc, one and one. Third, LaValle goes to second. That's going to take us to the bottom of the sixth. It's a very subdued Rigsby's team, actually, for these guys. They're usually jumping up and down on the screen at this point. kind of like both teams have just decided that Rigsbee's is going to win this, and they're just playing it out just for the heck of it.
Rip it hard, Chinwell, rip it hard.
Our score going to the bottom of the sixth is Rigsbee's 7, Barcomb's 1. This game, I hadn't even mentioned it yet. I always mention it at the start of the game. It's September 3rd, 1986. On a comfortable but cool Wednesday evening. This is Alan Fassett. On deck, Steve Chris.
Good eye, good eye. Come on in here, Ben!
Come on, Chipwell, what'd
you
say, huh?
Come on out.
Come on out.
Fire in your eyes. A chopper. Shortstop. Hawksby to first. One down.
Stevie, what do you say?
This will bring up Steve Chris, who's batting for Greg Fassett. One down. Third base. McDonough with the long throw. Lombard backing up. Chris will be standing at second. McDonough made a nice play on the ball, but probably would have been better if he'd hung on to it. Threw it about 10 feet over Boris' head. Bring up Gary Fassett, first baseman and team manager. That's a base hit. That scores Chris. It's now. Eight to one. That's me up Mark Rael. He's the right fielder. He swings at the first pitch. I think Bayshore and Southwick got their signals mixed up there. Rael goes all the way around. I guess it'll go in the book as a home run. But it should have been an out. Well, that makes two more runs. That gives them three this inning. That makes it 10 to 1. And Danny Caron will step in. He's going to swing at the first pitch right up the middle, slowed down by Hawksby. And Underwood wisely hung on to that one. A runner at first and Keith Riel, the batter. Nothing like scoring runs to get this Rigsbee's team excited. Underwood with a beautiful play. A beautiful play. A nice play to end the Rigsbee's scoring. Nice way to end the defensive end of the Barcomb season. It is 10 to 1. We're going to the top of the seventh. Barcombs, again, look like they're attending a funeral here instead of a softball game.
Come on, Gordon, one more time, babe.
There's our score.
Let's go, guys.
Denny Laporte will be the batter. Barcombs needs 9 runs this inning. And strike one hits the edge of the plate. One and one. There's a base hit for Laporte.
Okay, keep going, Ronnie. Let's go out.
He gets rid of his hat so he can run a lot faster. This will be Todd Underwood. One on and nobody out. I feel that was Real out there. He grabs it. One down. And Joey Trombley will step in.
Come on, Danny boy. What do you say? Clean on yourself!
That's strike one. Ball one.
Yeah!
Oh, beautiful catch by Gary Fassett. A mirror image of Greg Nettles or Brooks Robinson in their World Series exploits. That's a diving leap toward the foul line. A beautiful grab. And this brings up Rob McDonough with the opportunity to make the last out of the season for Barcomb. And it's a weak one. Karen will toss the first. And Barcombs goes out on a slow bouncer. Probably an appropriate way for them to end the season. They gave up midway through this ball game. Our final score, Rigsbee's 10, Barcombs TV and Furniture 1. Rigsbee's will go on now. They'll face the winner of the Press Republican Bowl Mart Lanes series. That'll be the finals of the Gentlemen's League. The Bowl Mart leads in that series as I'm taping this 2-0. The game will follow immediately here at South Acres.